of Team USA, who know that only one time in Olympic history has a group such as them won gold. Daunting for sure. Doable, absolutely. All they have to do starting tonight is be fabulous. And so has their time. It took everything they had.
Settle down, it'll all be clear. Don't pay no mind to the demons, they fill you with fear. The trouble, it might drag you down. If you get lost, you can always be found. Just know.
Once upon a time, from coast to coast, there were thousands. And now, all is said and done, and there are only five.
Just know we are not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place yours.
We welcome you inside the North Greenwich Arena, just east of central London. It is the opening day for women's gymnastics. This debut is called the qualification. There will be no medals awarded, but all the medal battles to come will be decided as far as who competes in them here in this competition. The United States in this third of five groups in the qualification will be with Canada, Great Britain, so we'll have fabulous atmosphere here, and France. One thing we can tell you is that the introduction to the night is so dramatic and so respectful that it's a good thing the athletes are backstage, Tim and Elfie, because I'm afraid they might melt.
Yeah, I tell you, I get chills every time I hear it.
You're looking at Gabby Douglas from Virginia Beach, Virginia. She went to Sean Johnson's gym in Des Moines, Iowa, left home to become an Olympian. Her coach, Ling Chow, said, "I'm not sure we have enough time," but obviously they've had enough time. It's been quite a week of preparation for her, and we'll be talking about that as we move along. We'll start things off with the United States on the vault. Kyla Ross will not compete in this rotation, but Allie Raisman will. So will Gabby Douglas there, number 411. Jordan Weber, who's the rock-solid performer of this team, and Michaela Maroney, who's been battling a bad toe.
Yeah, you know, so for this competition, it is four gymnasts compete, and one gymnast, you are able to drop that score. So they need the top three scores when the USA advances to the team final, and that is when, not if. They will count all three, only three up, and that was fantastic from Gabby. She has struggled on that on and off throughout this year. If she can do that, she's off to a tremendous start.
I also feel, Tim, that starting the competition with that young lady, Allie Raisman, is a fantastic decision because Marta Caroli wanted her on this team early on, and she has consistency.
But that is Jordan Weber, and if you would like to have the best on your team, you want her and you want this right here, Michaela Maroney. I said it at the Olympic trials, it would be harder for her to make the Olympic team than to secure gold here in London. She is far and away the best vaulter in the world.
There is Allie Raisman that Elfie was talking about from Needham, Massachusetts. So it's two California women, one from Massachusetts, one from Michigan, and one Virginia Beach / Iowa.
Allie told me every day this year, my goal, leave the gym, no regrets. Here we go. It's unbelievable how big of a start that was. Right there, that vault, there is not a country in the world that is going to have a vault, I believe, that's better than that. And she's the one that could get thrown out.
Boy, there's nothing like getting the first routine out of your system.
And she is, as Elfie mentioned, the perfect one. Marta Caroli calls her sturdy, and she is everything about that word, mentally, physically.
And really, Tim, this is the type of gymnastics we've been seeing from Allie all year long. She has never looked better than this moment. This fall, she has worked extra hard on cleaning up those little details, just a little bit of a form break there. Remember, that's in slow motion.
That's right. Just out of the park, as you see her personal coach, Mihai Breschin. The coaches will be tag teaming a little bit. They'll be coming in and out at different times.
In our scoring system, we go with a green, yellow, and red mark on the right-hand side. Green is obviously go. Good. Only 7/10 of deductions off that huge vault and a 15.8. So 1.2 deduction or less is green. That's Allie Raisman. 1.3 to 1.9 is, could go either way. And red is definitely not good. Here is Gabby Douglas. She could become one of the faces of these games.
She said she needs to just trust herself.
Raisman a little bit off center on the landing, but that's going to score higher than the highest score we've seen on vaulting so far in the competition.
Explain what's going on in the air here.
Well, she's going to leave the table, and what makes this so critical, there are a number of gymnasts at these Olympics that'll do twists. Right there, they would stop, but she goes all the way around, and look at her left hand guard. It opened up in the middle, and she had the, I guess, the patience and the belief in herself to not let it distract her.
The score for Gabby Douglas, a 10th better than her teammate, a 15.9. The USA is off to a fabulous start, and Jordan Weaver is next.
P&G presents Thank You, Mom.
My mom has been so great over the years, just constantly supporting me my whole gymnastics career.
Oh, that was really good, Jor.
From driving me to practice every single day to helping me with my laundry, she's always been there for me and helping me reach my goals. So I'm really thankful to have such a great mom. Thank you, Mom.
For unique perspectives every day of the games, visit NBCOlympics.com/Olympic17. P&G, proud sponsor of moms.
From DeWitt, Michigan comes Jordan Weaver, and since she came on the scene 3 years ago, she has been about as consistent as you can imagine.
And what you want to see in this team competition, we just saw Gabby Douglas post 15.9. You want those numbers to keep going up. She's capable of doing that. Same ball.
Just needs to get the landing. Very good. I don't know if that's going to go higher, though. She was well off to the side on the landing.
Could be the same.
You have no idea how dominant this Team USA is on vaulting. Right now, like I said, they've had three go up, and this vaulting score as a team will crush everybody in the world, and it's because they do this difficult vault, maximum starting score 16.5.
And what Jordan does so well is she executes. She has incredible power and lift off this vaulting table. Tries to glue those legs together right to the bitter end. The only error, the only small error, is right here on the landing.
The United States may be able to discard a very high score here. That's exactly what may happen, because Weaver puts up a 15.833, and their super vaulter is coming up, Michaela Maroney.
Yeah, there is nobody in the world right now. There's never been a female gymnast that vaults like Michaela Maroney. She is just out of this world. She has unbelievable technique, and because of that, she is able to just jump off the vaulting table to maybe 2.5 feet higher than just about anybody in the competition.
Michaela suffered a concussion at the Nationals in late June, came back to the trials. This week, she's had the most famous big toe in gymnastics.
Why?
She had a lot of excess energy there. That's huge.
That was ginormous. I'm telling you, that was at least 2 feet higher than anybody else in the world will fly. And, you know, she's amped up. It's the Olympic Games, and she almost had too much power.
And we've seen Michaela actually stick this vault cold. Look at that.
And she keeps going up. Everybody else is going down at that point, and she's still going up. And look at the time she has to finish it. But because of that, she takes that big step forward.
She's going to vault twice because that's what you need to do to get into the vault final, which will be a single event for a separate gold, silver, and bronze. She had a broken toe. She re-injured it, slammed it on the balance beam. It was heavily swelled up. It's still black and blue, but you wouldn't notice it. She doesn't limp at all.
Yeah, she said, hey, it's a toe.
And it's the Olympic Games.
This is the Olympics, and that's a toe, so it's not a factor.
And this is the reason why she's here. One event wonder. This is it.
Yeah, you know, I always thought she could make the team. In my heart, I really thought she could make the team by only doing vault. Marta Caroli said she didn't think so, but, and there she is. She is the women's coordinator. She oversees everything with this team, and they have had dramatic successes. They have, however, won the last two world championships before the Olympic Games. They've won them both, and they've had to settle for silver both times. They do not want that to happen three times in a row.
15.9. So the United States has really gotten off to an extraordinary start.
Now, remember, she's vaulting twice. The reason she's vaulting twice is to make it into the event finals where the top eight vaulters in the world. That was gorgeous.
That's the best I've ever seen her do that vault. It's kind of a cool thing to do the best gymnastics you've ever done at the Olympic Games.
So again, this is the last time in the Olympics there'll be some margin of error, but there weren't many errors in this vaulting display by the United States.
Now, this vault doesn't have the same maximum score as Michaela's first vault, but she still does it very clean. Look at the landing. That's where the improvement is. And it's a blind landing. Very difficult to stick this type of vault.
Let's take another look at what we're not going to call a vault. Let's call it the flight of Michaela Maroney.
They call her Air Maroney, and this is why she just keeps going up when everybody else is going down. Look at the height over the vaulting table. That is just obscene.
And a perfectly straight line. It's huge.
She's off the table by almost as much as she is tall. Awaiting the second tally, and it is a 15.7 for an average of 15.8 for Michaela Maroney. So the United States has set the bar about as high as you can imagine for everybody else, and Canada's in this group, Great Britain's in this group, but Romania, Russia, they're watching. What are they seeing?
Well, if they're watching, they are really bummed out right now because there is no team in the world that can even come close to matching what the USA just did on vaulting. Now, the USA has places where they're not quite as strong. For instance, the Russians, if they are great on bars, they're a little bit better than the USA there, but nobody comes close. There's not a more dominant team on any event in the Olympic Games than the Americans on vaulting.
And what we've been watching in practices, especially with the Russians, is they're capable of doing more. It's whether or not they'll actually come out and perform. Where the Americans have been performing these routines, the Russians have yet to prove themselves.
So now a short while for Team USA to wait for the rotation to come to an end, but at least they have positive things to think about while that's happening. One thing we look forward to is the same atmosphere we had yesterday when the Great Britain men left to a standing ovation. Here's Rebecca Tunney from Manchester in Great Britain, just north of here, and we'll find out if she can help do that.
and she is 15 years old. You can compete at 15 years old. You have to turn 16 in the Olympic Games. She said not many people can say they've been to the Olympics at 15, so that's quite an achievement.
And she's become their new star. She won the national championships this year. They have such high hopes for her. Last time we saw Rebecca, she actually came to the American Cup this past year. She did not have a good time on balance beam. It was a bit overwhelming for her to compete at the Garden.
Well, that's why I'm so curious to see what happens here, because it really did look like jitters and nerves at the American Cup. And yeah, that's a very big stage for a young girl, but nothing in comparison to competing in the Olympics at home.
And I know she didn't see this type of pageantry around the arena when she was here this past January, competed at the Olympic test event. Got a sense of this floor and this atmosphere, but it looks a little bit different now.
She's being very definite, very careful. Sometimes when you're that careful, you kind of have these little tiny adjustments everywhere.
Just the dismount.
Well, that's a tremendous start for her.
Rebecca Tunney overcoming what has to be mega adrenaline. So with their four great faults, the United States is going to be able to discard a score that other nations would die for. We move to the second rotation for Team USA. The next challenge, the uneven bars.
Jordan, just like an ultimate driving machine. I mean, she is like an amazingly tuned engine. Very, very focused, one of the strongest physically I've seen maybe since Nadia. Gabby, oh, we loved her because her personality, really just a little butterfly flying for here and there. Ali, the brain of the team, super intelligent, is a very well-structured mind. Kyla, a beautiful athlete. She's grown unbelievable since we've seen her as first time popping up in the national team. Oh, Maroney. With her style, obviously, she's going to be a really good shape, particularly in front of the European judges. With her temperament and her head hold and the way how she's going up and down, it is unique. It's absolutely unique. All this combination is really made a perfect setup for the highest quality athletic performance.
The one and only Bella Karolyi. No matter where you see him, his heart is always in the arena. Team USA now go to the uneven bars, and we take a look at the order selected by Marta Karolyi and her staff. It will be Ali Raisman in your screen. Jordan Weber. Kyla Ross makes her debut today. She's the youngest member of the team. She'll turn 16 later on this year. Gabby Douglas and Michaela Maroney will sit this one out. She's done her job. What challenges does this apparatus present, considering the recent mindset of Team USA?
Well, you know, this was actually an event where the USA, if they were worried about an event, it was the uneven bars, and that's one of the reasons, not really why Ali made the team, but Kyla Ross, you know, she really contributes on the uneven bars, has a beautiful look, as does Gabby Douglas. She is world class, as you see her warming up here.
Come on, Gabby.
They're very good on the bars. As I mentioned earlier, Russia potentially a little bit better. But to give you some perspective, the USA crushed the world at the last World Championships on vaulting, and they just averaged 0.2 higher on each vault. So not only were they way better in 2011, they got even more dominant.
Don't play poker with this woman. She never lets it show.
Absolutely not. And she is thrilled to be in this position because I'll tell you what, she will do everything in her power to put in a high score to set this team off. She has been practicing extremely hard in practice. I noticed the little things that she was paying attention to.
But this is not Allie's strength. You know, she's a great table setter because you can depend on her, but she has some small little feet issues. You see them coming apart. Another release right there. It's just get through this routine, though. That's the whole key. Here comes the dismount right here. Another hit routine.
Yeah, she's done her job again.
Question is, how will they score it?
Well, this is a routine they want to throw out.
Don't tell that to the parents. Here's Lynn and Rick Raisman watching that routine. Listen.
Come on, Allie. Come on, Allie. Come on, Allie. You got it.
School gymnast, and it looked as though she knew every part of that routine.
Wow, that was incredible. Sometimes the more you know, the worse it is, too.
In the competition setting to the Olympics, we've seen Rita Weber as well watching her daughter, and sometimes she can watch, and sometimes she can't. Usually she gets good news.
And you know, Jordan Weber obviously comes in the reigning world champion, so she is the favorite by default because of that title, and she has earned every bit of it. She did, however, fall short at the Olympic trials and lost to Gabby Douglas, but her coach, John Gettard, had told me, you know what, it's a lot easier to be chasing than to get chased, and so maybe that's a good omen for them.
You saw the yellow next to the score of Allie Raisman. That's exactly what Tim and Elfie were talking about. Not sure. 14.166.
Boy, and there is absolutely nothing you can do sitting in the stands. There's Marta Caroli watching this team. But Jordan comes in so well prepared. She is physically fit, top of her game. We've watched her in practice at the Olympic trials. I remember thinking, wow, she was winning every workout, just cruising through each and every workout.
If there's a place where nerves can come into play, it can be on this sequence right here. But that was great. And now right here, she also has struggled in the past. Holds on, though. Listing double layout.
Two down, two to go.
Her coach, John Gettard.
Come on, Kyla.
He actually was named the head coach of Team USA, and he tweeted that, he told me, before it was an official announcement, got his hand slapped, but he said, I was just so excited.
Just how tough a competitor this athlete is. She was not about to get off that bar, but this dismount, she's thinking, oh, I had a little bobble up there. I'm going to nail this one.
Parents getting so much attention as they deserve in these Olympics. See, that's what happens when you watch.
Come on, Kyla, you got it.
So there was that one little pause, a save. And the score for Jordan Weber, a 14.833. A yellow mark next to that, and that's, of course, because she's so good. Continuing with one of the two women from California on Team USA, this is Kyla Ross. As the Olympics approached, she heard too young, too young, too young, but Marta Crowley saw something.
Yeah, and what she saw is this exquisite line of hers, and this is something that plays well on an international stage.
Little bit of a leg separation on that, but
actually hit the low bar.
Has very clean form, nice lines. And this event right here is one of the reasons that she is in London. She helps Team USA in the place where they are weakest. Routine, though.
Solid routine, but yeah. Had a little bit of a form break, as we mentioned. I think she clipped that low bar.
I think some people might be saying, wait a minute, we're seeing 15.8s, 15.8s on the vault. Now, all of a sudden, Team USA looks almost as good, but the scores are way in the 14s. What's going on there?
Well, it just comes down to that vaulting, if you are capable of bringing in that big vault, that Aminar, that the possibilities are almost endless. But these are more typical scores that you'll see on the other three events.
Back to Gabby Douglas, who so easily sells herself with a smile that you'd never forget. It was her sister that convinced the family to put her in gymnastics. And because she was so good, they decided to move to West Des Moines, Iowa, to that man's gym, Liang Chow. He had groomed an Olympic gold medalist that she could watch on television, and Sean Johnson. It seemed to be a fabulous decision to leave home and make the move west. Kyla Ross, a 14.866.
Yeah, that is a little disappointing for Team USA. They certainly were hoping for a 15-1 or 2, but really, there's absolutely no possible way that the USA isn't going to advance in one of the very top spots.
But the potential for this routine from Gabby Douglas is huge. This is why she is the last athlete up. Her maximum score is 16.6.
This is why she's so great. She flies. Big release combination, down to the low. People worried that she'd have nerves here. Nerves of steel.
Good to have a little review of what just went on, and what happened in that routine was incredible height of her release skills. It's kind of like men's high bar. You know how we all love when they fly. Well, this young lady, she does just that, not just once, but on a second release skill. It's beautiful.
She's the Michaela Maroney of the uneven bars. I don't think anybody gets more air than her. This was a great routine for Gabby. Picks up a little bit of speed on this giant to generate some power. Nice stretch in the air. See how she lands with her chest up like that? That incurs no deductions. Should be a very big score, 15-4 or better.
So summarize how the U.S. has gone halfway.
They've done okay. It could have been a little bit better, but that's a great score.
Just over the mark of 1.2 in deductions, but a 15.333 for Team USA. They're halfway finished.
Yeah, and really, they couldn't ask for anything better. Yes, they could have been a little crisper on the uneven bars, but vaulting was dominant, dominant, dominant.
When London was awarded the Olympic Games, as we take you over to the floor, everybody wondered, is Elizabeth Tweddle going to be able to hang around for that unbelievable honor? And she has. You are looking at the greatest gymnast Great Britain has ever produced, the first one to ever win a world and a European medal.
Thank you.
James Bond can't do that.
That was brilliant. It's all in the music.
Agent 00354, Beth Tweddle of Great Britain. Team USA heads to the crucible that is the balance beam, but halfway through, there's no better way to appreciate what these young women do than one frame at a time. Beam is up next for Team USA. This is the women's qualification. Four up, three scores count. You can advance to the team, the event, and the all-around final if you're great enough. It will be Kyla Ross, Gabby Douglas, Jordan Weaver, and Allie Raisman. Michaela Maroney did her thing on the vault. So as we return to the balance beam, next time you park your car, stand on the yellow line and imagine jumping up and landing on your feet after being upside down. Wait a minute, she wants to get that out of her system.
Yeah, that's two falls.
Very rattled.
You don't see that from Jordan Weaver.
What's the best way, Tim, that you learned in your career to put that out of your mind once it's happened?
Well, you know what? The best athletes in the world, like Jordan, that doesn't rattle them. That makes them even tougher, and I believe that will be the case with Jordan Weaver. It's like, oh, I'm not going to do that.
Now, again, the powerful nations that will compete for the United States for that gold medal, China, Russia, Romania, they will come later. And that will round out the eight that go to the team final, the eight that go to each event final of the four that we're watching, and the 24 that will go to the all-around final, which is the best athlete on all four apparatus combined. Gabrielle Douglas going through in her mind what she hopes happens on the balance beam. And so far, she is the leader in the all-around. And we should also tell you that any one country can only send two.
And so that means that one of them is not going to make it into the all-around finals. That's a fact. Two will, for absolute certain.
Kyla Ross gets things started for the American team. I think this was a really good choice. She's steady, calm.
You know, I talked to her after they had their training out on the official equipment, and I said, Kyla, you know, throughout the trials process, you looked a little jittery, and you've always been known as that kid who could block everything out. But in the training here, the biggest moment of her life, she looked rock solid, and she said, yeah, I guess the trials were a little bit more pressure than even being here, as many top athletes often feel. And teams as powerful as the USA.
Tim, the only problem she had in the podium training, that was the last time she was up on this beam, was this move right here. Not an issue today. Just that dismount.
For this young lady. Incredible.
Saw Michaela Maroney's excitement, that's for sure. What sets apart Gabby Douglas? Why do you think she's been so popular?
She just got that smile, and she laughs, and she jokes around. You know, she'll give it back to you, too. If you play with her, she will give it right back to you. So she's charming. That's all there is to it. But beyond that, you know, Marta doesn't really care about charm. I can guarantee you that. But she has all of the gymnastics qualities that make up the truly best. She is quick. She's light. She is extremely flexible, and she's able to do some of the most intricate skills in the world.
Everyone used to tell me that you have a great smile.
I just love to smile, and everyone just tells me, you should just show off your smile because you have a great face and great smile, and ever since then, I can't stop smiling.
There was no smile when the decision was made to leave home to get better. Enter Liang Chao.
I had to get better coaching. If I wanted to make this dream come real, then I need to move away and actually make it happen and make it possible.
The only doubt that I had was, would it pay off in the end? Would she get to where she needs to get? Is this going to be worth it?
Being separated from her is the absolute hardest thing. Second hardest thing, the financial commitment.
You know, she's a single mom. She's done everything for us. It hurts me when she's stressed out and when she's trying to make ends meet. It's very hard.
Homesickness.
It was very difficult.
Every day I just cried. I'd bawl my eyes out. I didn't know how to handle it. At some point, even the strongest person can crack.
All the time, all the years, all the literally blood, sweat, and tears. And then, you know, they come to you one day and say, I want to quit.
We pretty much told her, this is your dream. This is for you. Don't worry about anybody else but yourself. Because at the end of the day, the only person that will be disappointed is you.
It all worked.
To see that smile on her face, that's the only thing that makes it bearable. To know that, deep down inside, she's really happy doing the thing that she loves the most.
Wow, I finally made it. And it's just such an honor just to have, you know, people call you an Olympian.
And now with a smile, the final debriefing from her coach, Liang Chao.
And actually, though, on this event, it's been the place where Gabby can get a little bit rattled. She's either really on or she's not at all.
And she gets angry about that at national championships when she had a fall. She said she just felt like kicking a chair. That's how angry she was. She said she really has to focus on the easy parts of her routine. Sometimes she lets her mind wander. Focus. That's what she has to trust.
And being in the all-around was no guarantee.
Oh, no. Yeah. She actually looked a little bit inconsistent on vault, and there was rumor that she'd be left off. Okay, comes up right here, this sequence, and this, the end of this one right here. Hey. That was good, but you can tell she is just very antsy about it.
Now, followed up by a big skill here. And I'll tell you, she has that little
tiny balance check in the beginning.
This is one of the best routines we've seen her do.
Yeah, everybody was so nervous. How is Gabby going to deal with this pressure? Her coach, Lan Chow, said that's her biggest challenge in gymnastics so far today.
Sometimes this can be a little bit offside, just the dismount.
Was that a stick?
No, it's not going to be a stick. She's going to get a deduction for lifting that one leg up, but that was for Gabby Douglas.
Relief.
Grand slam home run.
Come on, Jeff, keep it going. Come on.
You heard Kyla Ross on the left there. Her score of 15.075. She said keep it going probably would be a good idea.
So this is the element that she has struggled on. And it's actually very good. She just doubts herself on it, and she recognizes that.
And she knows about that move. She has been practicing that so often in the training gyms. This one, no problem at all. A full twist, back tuck. Spot on.
And look at those eyes right there. They will look at the beam for as long as possible. She's got to take them off right here. But they are a big tool, and if you don't use them, you're crazy.
And sometimes getting a little nervous, a little bit offside on that dismount, but not today. She has worked hard on this routine to perfect it for this moment.
You see Coach Lang Chow in the background jumping with joy. He is so happy to have that one out of the way.
Next up will be Jordan Weber. Team USA's had so much fun posing for pictures with Ryan Lochte. They've been evidently practicing their British accents. Not sure how that's going.
And where Jordan has always been amazing is balance beam. She has struggled in many major competitions on bars. A 15.266 for Gabby, just on the line of being a green score, which is great. That's still a very good job, and she's going to be very happy with that.
What Jordan has to do now is trust the training that she has put into the preparation of this routine.
She always has.
Saw her get rattled in that warm-up. Wasn't the type of warm-up she would have wanted. She has a lot of difficult skills, and it starts off right here. Really tough combination here.
That they had made. They were connecting those two skills, and John told me, her coach, before the meet, when they made the change, all of the nerves went away, and it shows right there. Oh, wow. A little back on her heels on that, and you land on your heels sideways, and you are usually looking at the ground
just
as your feet hit it.
Full turn. She just rushed it a little bit, setting up for her final piece of gymnastics, the dismount.
Very solid for Jordan. Could be a little bit better, but certainly still going to get a very big score.
Sometimes I wonder, Tim, what do you admire most? An unbelievable routine or an unbelievable fight out of a very, very precarious situation? Getter talking about event finals, right?
Yes, he is. He cannot let her mind relax, but watch this. If you land on your heels completely and she is just too far back there, but it was a tremendous save.
my goodness.
Oh, oh.
Squeezing. Look at those toes in the front.
Yeah.
Gripping all of 4 inches of balance beam.
Those toes could crack walnuts.
Allie Raisman, and she would be the final member of Team USA to go on the balance beam.
Go, Allie. Come on, Allie. Come on, Allie.
So what John was saying, though, is, you know, only two will qualify to the all-around finals. And
come on, Allie. You got it.
Jordan opened the door a little bit there.
He's putting the pressure on her.
Yeah.
He's letting her know exactly where she stands going into floor exercise.
And Allie Raisman can put up a very big number on balance beam. She's the U.S. champion on both this event and the next one, floor exercise.
Here's the score for Jordan Weber, 14.7, 1.3 deductions. When we come back, Allie Raisman on the beam. We remember that day a couple of years ago in Worcester, Massachusetts, and it was an event that had everybody sitting next to me right now, Elfie Schlegel and Tim Gaggett, saying, Allie, who? And that was her coming out party.
And look at her now. Anchoring this team on balance beam, she won the national title, as Tim has mentioned. She's earned this position. She's earned it.
Yeah, in that competition, an American Cup, she not only performed tremendously, she was better than she really had any right to be.
Dismount, one of the most difficult dismounts being performed on women's balance beam.
It's called a Patterson, named after Olympic champion Carly Patterson. Really good.
And it's 3 out of 4 for the United States.
And this is what I don't think any other team in the world can muster. I don't believe that they can go through a competition. The USA has had no misses thus far. Not even a place where it looked like they were definitely going to miss.
But it's no surprise, because we've watched them do it in practice all week long.
And they head to the floor exercise, which to me has almost been an American tradition.
But there are lots of games going on in between games. They're all very close, good friends. But Allie Raisman, she wants to be in the all-around finals, without a doubt. If she is, she is a definite medal contender. And with Jordan getting that low score on beam, and with Allie going to floor and competing last, it's a possibility.
So on this particular night, there may be one member of Team USA who's extremely excited to make the team final, but extremely disappointed to be left out of the all-around picture. The women head to the final rotation in this women's qualification. At the North Greenwich Arena, Team USA has moved to the final rotation of the four women compete in. That will be floor exercise. A couple of things going on here tonight in this qualification. The top 24 will go to the all-around, which is the best overall gymnast on all four apparatus. However, only two can go for any one country. And Gabby Douglas right now leads Jordan Weber by a lot, 1.133. And Jordan Weber leads Allie Raisman by 0.3. But Allie Raisman just picked up 0.4 on the balance beam when they dropped Jordan Weber's score and took the best three.
And Allie Raisman, on this event, she has the most difficult, highest potential. potential score being done in the world today. A 16.5 is possible for her, which is more, you see Allie right there, which is more than Jordan Weaver's maximum score. And she's a world medalist.
Don't I remember Jonathan Horton being in the world championships in the top five, however, being the third best American and missing out on the all-around?
That would be the 2011 Worlds. That's exactly what happened.
And he said it's crazy, but it's the rule. So everybody knows the rule going in. Kyla Ross, Gabby Douglas, Jordan Weaver, and Allie Raisman, Michaela Maroney only competed on the vault. Kyla Ross and Michaela Maroney will always be sharing private thoughts. That's what happens when you learn each other's game so long ago in the very same gym.
I've known Michaela since I was, like, really little. To be friends from, like, the same town growing up is awesome. We get to go to the Olympics together.
I remember the first time that I saw her. That was her first day at the gym. She was, like, so strong and little. Oh, my gosh. She, like, climbed the rope in, like, 3 seconds. And I asked her, how do you do that? Ever since then, we've been best friends.
We always just got up on the beam and just play around.
It's so crazy. I'm on the Olympic team with a girl that I've known since I was 6 years old, and my teammate and my best friend. Like, come on.
You know, Elfie, when you become known to each other at such a young age and you take the journey all the way to the Olympic Games, I have to figure, and your friends from gymnast days back in Florida for life, you just will always walk together forever.
They will always remember this moment, and to think that they started together as such young little girls, you wonder what they talked about back then, but they will have plenty to talk about following this experience. It's really beautiful.
And that photo was oh so cute. Point, but also she'll incur a few more for the landing deduction.
To remember that all the great scores that Team USA has gotten and the mistakes that we just saw from Kyla Ross all go out. The mission tonight is to have your best day, see what happens, and get the team into the top eight.
Those aren't typical mistakes that we see from Kyla.
The assistant coach, Jenny Zhang.
We always compliment her on the fact that she's so cat-like on landings, and that's what's made her gymnastics so special. Now, this floor exercise is really bouncy. She just hasn't been able to adjust to that extra spring, and that's a large deduction.
The reason I say that, Kyla Ross will be one who's happy to know that that score that she'll get and all the scores from this qualification will be erased. Gabby Douglas next to go for the team from the United States. You're looking at Gabby Douglas of Team USA. It's women's qualification day on day two of the 30th Olympiad. How's her day been in your eyes?
Oh, it's been tremendous, without a doubt. You know, and she is the one person that everybody really was worried about. You know, it's if Gabby is on, she is not just world class. She can battle for the Olympic gold medal in the all around. But when she's off, things can really get messy very quick.
Team USA will not want to keep the Kyla Ross score of 13.733.
I believe that's the first 13 they've gotten the entire competition. Deduction, because not did she just step out of bounds, but both feet were out of bounds, and 2 3-tenths steps plus 3 tenths for out of bounds, almost a point.
Sailing along a little uh-oh.
Yeah, and that was not a little uh-oh, because that would be the first major break. I would call that a major break for Team USA and Gabby. She just is way over rotated on this, and so this leap that is supposed to rebound and go straight up flies forward. And you see those steps, both feet out of bounds, 3 tenths off for that. And all of those steps, every time you move your feet, judges pens down to paper.
Oh, that's scary.
Now Jordan Weaver, Team USA, needs some good floor exercise news.
What we have seen from Jordan, especially on this event, is the ability to just be rock solid on her landings. And that's exactly what she's going to need in this routine. She can't afford to move a muscle.
So Jordan Weaver is going to do this for herself and the eventual floor exercise final, and for her team. Because now they're going to definitely have to count a low score.
But remember, Gabby came into this round with about a point over Jordan Weaver. And she basically handed that back to Jordan with that mishap.
Crowd reaction for some good news for Great Britain on the uneven bars. Four events going on simultaneously here. And it's taking some time to calculate all those steps.
Yeah, when there are mistakes, you know, and some judges, you know, when they're flying out of bounds like that, you can be distracted. How many steps did you actually take? Because, like I said, every time you move your feet, that's a deduction.
Mark Rowley in deep concentration, looking up at the scoreboard where she can see numbers and she can see replays of what's going on here.
I tell you, though, Gabby just really opened it up for both Jordan and Allie.
Yeah, for Jordan, her all-around hopes are very much alive. This is a great set.
And Allie Raisman, too?
Absolutely. Allie has the advantage, of course, going last.
One of the great skills I think you can acquire in gymnastics is what do you do to effectively kill the time where you're doing this and you're doing what Raisman is doing.
It's the worst in the world. It's the one thing that you truly have no control over. And I'll tell you, when they take this long to get a score, it usually means nothing but bad news.
Gabby Douglas gets a 13.766, which is actually a little better than Kyla Ross. Surprised?
No, you know, just for some perspective, she scored a 15.175 a bunch of times this year.
Boy, that really hurts.
And now what felt like an insurmountable lead for Gabby Douglas is very vulnerable. Weber needs just a 14.899 to take over the lead in the all-around.
And I guarantee you that Jordan saw that score from Gabby Douglas up on that scoreboard. She saw it. She's standing in the corner, and this can make her better. This can give her the motivation.
She got a lot of very challenging tumbling passes as well, though. You know, she takes the risk, hoping to get the reward, but...
And that risk will come right off the top with her opening tumbling pass. It's a big skill.
She gets a deduction for that. I tell you, though, looking at the floor scores and how things are going down here, it appears that they're being a little stricter on this event than any other.
Remember, Jordan Weber needs better than 14.899 to take over the all-around lead.
I think she's going to do that, but it could be very close.
She sure did make it interesting stepping out of bounds.
So this is the type of competition that Carly Patterson had to survive and did. It's the kind of competition that Nastia Lukin had to survive and did. And as good as Gabby Douglas and Allie Raisman and Jordan Weber are, one of them's going to be out. Just as Gabby Douglas had to wait, Jordan Weber does too.
Well, remember, Allie still has to get the job done herself as well. She's great on floor, though.
So for a time, Team USA felt like a juggernaut. Then suddenly the ship sprung a leak.
team is still, without a doubt, going to be in the team finals easily.
You know what I mean, Tim? I mean,
yes, I do.
You watch them, and almost if you're one of the other teams, you could be intimidated by how good they were, and then suddenly...
Yeah, and once again, we have this long pause. And it always, the longer the pause, it seems like the bigger the deductions. I don't know why that happens, but...
Some nervous chatter to kill the time, but the score is in, and Jordan Weaver will not catch Gabby Douglas, 14-6-6-6. And with our scoring system, we've told you, yellow means it can go either way. It's a cautious number. Gabby Douglas is going to go into the all-around. For the past few months, it's been Weaver beats Douglas, Douglas beats Weaver. And now it's Allie Raisman, who has a 14-9-6-6 to qualify for the all-around final and eliminate Weaver.
And nobody's been talking about Allie Raisman in the all-around, and it's something that she has told us, that she wants to be considered an all-around gymnast. Allie, here's your chance.
Decision was made by Allie Raisman and Mihai Brezjan. What music do you want to use? And they picked Haban Aguila, and now all these months and all these practices later, she needed maybe a little extra. And the crowd got into it, the rhythmic clapping, the arena was all hers, and who knows? Maybe they gave her the boost.
It's okay, thank you. I could feel it in my glasses.
15.2, and Allie Raisman is in, period. 15.199 is what she needs better than to move ahead of Gabby Douglas.
And that is a very big score from what we have just seen from these judges.
But what we have to remember is she did come in with the highest maximum score.
And Raisman needs better than a 14.966 to move ahead of Jordan Weaver. So it's coming down to maybe tenths or thousands, and it's that silly step that Tim and Elfie are always talking about, perhaps. That little hop. All eyes on the scoreboard. Yeah, it's got to be so awkward, right?
Oh, yeah. It's extremely awkward. You know, they are friends, but they are very fierce competitors as well.
Can you please just line up and...
That's it for the competition. And Raisman is in. She is in. And Jordan Weaver is out of the all-around.
I guess.
To have watched Jordan Weaver these last few years, her destiny seems so much different than this.
Yeah, this is really almost unthinkable,
shocking.
To be honest.
It is. It's shocking.
And once again, the tears flow for Team USA, but we said when we first joined you from here, at the end of the day, one American is going to have the joy of trying to go for a team medal. Someone was going to be vastly disappointed to not have a chance to be where Carly and Nastia stood.
Jordan, she is the reigning world champion. That's how good the USA is. She's the reigning world champ, and she doesn't advance.
It's almost a shame with the new rules to not see all three in the all-around competition. There's a lot of pressure out there.
Here's how Allie Raisman's parents, Lynn and Rick, watch the announcement.
United States Senator from the Green Bill then to the rank of 181.863 and Great Britain behind 170.656.
To Andrea Joyce to hear from their daughter.
Well, it may be the team preliminary competition, but it was an intense battle for those two U.S. all-around spots. Did you sense that out there, and can you believe this moment?
I can't even believe it. I just saw me high jump. I had no idea what was going on. I'm so happy, and I don't even know what's going on. I'm speechless.
So you were not aware through the competition how close this was?
No, not at all. I don't even know my scores besides bars and beams.
Did you have a sense that coming in under the radar might work in your favor?
I was hoping for it. I did all around the past 2 years, so I just wanted to do the same thing and hopefully be an all around again.
You may have surprised some people. Did you surprise yourself?
No. I mean, Mihai and my coaches and my family, they all believed in me. I always dreamed of being in the all around, so that was always my goal.
Is this emotional? It looked like it was at first.
Yeah, I don't know. This new thing, I always like cry when I'm happy. I think when I walked in, I almost started tearing up just being here. I'm so excited and so honored.
Hey, congratulations.
Thank you so much.
It's still not time to talk to Jordan Weaver. She's still right there. Back down to Andrea Joyce.
An intense battle for those two all-around spots for the American team. What went through your mind after Florida? Did you think that maybe you had lost it?
No. Of course, I made a little mistake, but, you know, all the rest of the events were pretty good, so I was very confident and very confident going to this meet, and I'm very excited to do the all-around.
People had worried about your nerves coming into this. How did you keep it in check?
Kept in check by doing a lot of numbers in the gym, a lot of pressure sets, and you know, my coach, he just told me to, you know, believe in yourself and never doubt. And I've been meditating on scriptures saying be confident in this, and you know, the Bible really helps me, so I was very confident.
How difficult is this for you guys as a team when only two can make it to the all-around?
It's very hard. I mean, the spots, you know, two only make it to the all-around, and it's very, you know, very tight, just like the five slots in the team is very tight, but you know, you just have to go out there and perform your best and, you know, get it.
You said it was a dream come true to make the Olympic team. What is it like to make the all-around finals?
Make the all-around finals is definitely amazing. And you know what? If we just take this into the all-around and team finals, then we definitely are going to secure a spot.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
And there's a flip side to that smile, and this is it. We're going to give Jordan Weaver a chance to gather herself and gather her thoughts. We will hear from the reigning world champion in a moment. We are back in a still buzzing North Greenwich Arena, and that's not the buzz because the United States has easily qualified for the team final, beating Great Britain by 11. They're the first of the four powerhouses to come. Later tonight, you'll see what China and Russia look like, and you'll get a look at Romania in our late night coverage. The buzz was because of what happened in today's qualification, and that was that Jordan Weaver was eliminated by 0.233, essentially that slide on the floor exercise. And she is with our Andrea Joyce.
Well, we have been able to see that this is a very emotional time for you, Jordan. Can you put into words what the last couple of minutes have been like for you?
It's a little bit of a disappointment. You know, it's always been a dream of mine to compete in the all-around at the Olympics and shoot for that gold medal. But, you know, I'm really proud of Allie and Gabby both, and I'm happy that they both made it to the all-around, and I'm glad that I'll be able to help the team out in team finals.
Was there any point during the competition where you were aware of how close it was and felt like it might be in danger?
I think, you know, from the very beginning, we were all looking very strong, and, you know, I knew it was going to be close between the three of us all doing all-around, but, you know, in the end, it is what it is, so.
You are a bit of a scoreboard watcher. I know that you've told me that in the past. During that final rotation, having to watch Allie go up last, what was going through your mind?
It was hard because, of course, I wanted that spot, but I also, you know, wanted to do Allie to do her best also for the team and for herself, so it was hard.
Okay, we'll see you in the team finals.
Thank you.
Ooh, wow. We're used to seeing Jordan Weaver do the winning thing. It took her a few seconds there, but she said the right thing. Now, Tim, you had an Olympic dream come true, and you had one ripped away and a shredded leg that still bears a scar. What's she going through?
Well, quite honestly, it's horrific. And, you know, I think at some point she will come to terms and have peace with this, but she will remember it forever. But on a different note, her balance beam and her floor, yes, she had some errors, but looking at everybody else throughout the competition, I do believe that she was underscored on both of those events.
Tough to gather herself, I'm sure. Elfie, she'll have 48 hours for the team final representing the United States. What do you think we'll see?
Well, once she lets everything settle down and she can actually think about what happened on this evening, I really believe that Jordan will come out the fighter, the champion that we have all seen in this young lady throughout the year. She certainly doesn't want it to end on this note.
And finally, Tim, I'm sure some people are saying, why do they have a rule like that? Why not send all the best in?
Well, absolutely. The 24 best all-around gymnasts in the world are absolutely not competing in the all-around finals. And I personally think that that's a travesty.
Well, it didn't take long. In fact, just one day for Jordan Weaver to become one of the most sympathetic figures in these Olympic Games. She'll compete in the team final in 2 days.
Okay, we welcome in Bella Caroli now, coach of Nadia Comaneci, Mary Lou Retton, and Kerry Strug, our group out at the venue. We're talking about the rule that limits not just the United States, but any country to no more than two competitors in the all-round final. And that means that Jordan Weaver, by the narrowest of margins, reigning world champion, will not get a shot at a medal.
Bob, you just mentioned a minute ago, this is the all-around final. The final best gymnast in the world should be lined up over there and dispute the ultimate and the highest and the most important ranking in the world to become an all-around champion, Olympic champion. Now, how you explain it to me that the third or fourth ranked gymnast on that order is eliminated because she is accidentally from the same country like other people with the same kind of gymnastic values? This is absolutely unacceptable.
So in your view, regardless of the country, Russia, Romania, China, the United States, whatever it may be, they should take the top 24. And if that means that more than two from a given country make it on that list, fine.
It is an Olympic final. The first 24 should be in the competition, nobody else.
To put it in context compared to another sport, it would be as if in the NCAA basketball tournament, the third best team in the ACC or the third best team in the Big Ten couldn't go, even though obviously they'd be better than most of the teams in the field. Dozens and dozens of young women competed. Jordan Weaver's going to be among the top four or five, but not among the final 24.
That's correct. And my heart is breaking just thinking about, you know, her state of mind right now, wondering why I've been eliminated. I'm the reigning world champion still, and I have the potential, and I have the drive. Why don't let me go?
Well, let's take a look at the few miscues that cost her a spot in the final.
Yeah. Well, right here. There is a minor mistake. A tenth and a half goes away. No complaint about that. Rest of the routine was powerful. Here on the beam also. There is one minor mistake. Yes, a tenth and a half goes away. But I'm asking, where is the rest of the tenths went away? Why she was so brutally underscored? Now, this is my question. Here it is again. A high value floor routine underscored drastically.
Well, they're going to need her in the team final on Tuesday. She's going to contribute 4 of the 12 routines. She has to pull it together.
They're needing her, and they're going to get her. And they will get her coming out and swinging big time. She's a powerful athlete. She's a smart athlete. She's the one who wants to show to the world that she's still the best gymnast of the world. She's a reigning world champion. She's going to come and going to help the team to conquer what is the ultimate dream, to become an Olympic gold medalist.
She also likely has a shot at an individual medal in the floor coming up. So again, her state of mind, she's got to put this behind her somehow.
She has to put behind, and she will put behind that. I know her, and I guarantee she's going to have a great competition coming up.